Hello students, welcome back to the mathematics class. Today I would like to discuss with you exercise 1.3 of question number 11. Okay, so here we have the question. If the sum of the first n terms of an AP is 4n minus of n square, what is the first term? Okay, so sum of the first n terms, they are given 4n minus of n square, what is the first term? Okay, what is the sum of first two terms? What is the sum of first two terms? Well, so what is the second term? What is the second term also we need to find. Similarly, find third and the tenth term and the nth term. Okay, so just you can see they are given question number 11. We have sum, they are given 4n minus of n square. Okay, this they are given. So once this they are given means what we need to find. So we need to find sum of first term and second term, and sum of second terms, and we need to find nth term, even though tenth term we need to find. Okay, these all things we need to find here. So now we know it very well. So n is equal to, we'll take 1, 2, 3, so on. So substitute here. So once you substituted, n is equal to 1. So 4 into 1 minus of 1 square. Okay, so how much will you get? S1 is equal to, okay, 4 into 1 is 4 minus of 1 square. So we'll get 3, and this is what? A1. So A1 or S1 is equal to, we'll get here, for even though this is sum of first term, and this is what? A1, first term also, 3. Okay, we'll get here 3. Now next one, S2, we need sum of first two terms. Okay, A1 plus of A2 we can write. I'll take equation number 1 it is. Okay, now can we have S2? We don't have S2, so we need to find S2. So S2, how we can find? This is, we can substitute in this equation. So this is 4 into 2 minus of 2 square. Okay, now how much will we get? S2 is equal to 4 into 2 is 8. 8 minus of, again we'll get, this is 4. Okay, so S2 is equal to, how much will you get? 4. Now once you got S2, 4 in substitute. Okay, this equation in 1. In equation 1, this one in equation 1 means we have S2 is equal to already 4. So now A1, so A1 plus of A2. Now 4 keep as it is, A1 how much we have? Okay, so A1 we have 3 plus of A2. Now this you can take this side, so A2 is equal to 1. So now once you got A2 is equal to 1, okay, now A1 we have 3, A2 is equal to 1. Now what we need to find here? Again we need to find S3 and A3. Okay, now so for S3 is equal to, we can write it is A1 plus A2 plus A3. Okay, can we have S3? We don't have. We need to find S3. How we can find? S3 is equal to 4 into 3 minus of 3 square, n square it is. Okay, now S3 is equal to 4, 3 is 12, and this is 3 square is 9 we'll get. Okay, now S3 is equal to 12 minus of 9, we'll get 3. Okay, so once you got S3 is equal to 3, now we need to find A3. So this is very simple. So I'll take this as equation 2 in 2. Okay, in 2. So now S3 is equal to, okay, so S3 already we have. So directly I'll substitute here. S3 we have 3 is equal to A1 we have 3 plus A2 we have 1 plus of A3 we need. So A3 is equal to, this is, we can say 4, okay, and minus 4 plus 3, okay. So this we can transfer this side, means it is what? Minus. So A3 you will get minus 1, okay. Now just you can see, we have A1 is 3, A2 is 1 here, okay. So A2 is 1 and A3 will get here minus 1. So S3 will get here 3. So this is, otherwise do one thing, S2, if you want to get the what? A3. So this here S3 minus of S2 where we have here, okay. So S3 we have how much? 3. 3, if you did like this also, you will get this S3 minus of S2, how much you will get? Again 3 minus of 4, you will get A3, okay. So minus 1, okay. Well, this is, now we need to find 10th term. So A10 is equal to, we have A plus n minus 1 into d. Now a 10, keep as it is here. A first term we have 3 plus this is 9 minus 10 minus 1, we will get 9 into d. Common difference, how much we have? A2 minus of 1, this is 2. Okay, now a 10 is equal to, okay, now this is 3, keep as it is. Now 9 2s will get 18. Now a 10 is equal to, will get minus 15. A 10 is equal to minus 15. Okay, once you got a 10 is equal to minus 15, 10th term, and we need to find nth term, even though we need to find nth term. So n is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This we need to find here. So is it looking to you, pupils? Let me check. Yes, well. Now a we have, it is 3 plus n minus of 1 as it is, and d we have 2. Okay. Now this is very simple. A n we need to find. 3 keep as it is. Now this is 2 into minus 2 and this is minus 2. Okay. Now an is equal to, we have an is equal to 3 minus 2, we will get how much it is. Okay, this is minus into minus plus 3 plus 2, will get 5 minus of 2n. So we will get nth term is what? 5 minus of 2n, 10th term is 15, S3 is 3, A2 is 1, A3 is 1, and S1, A1 is equal to 3. Okay, this is what the question number 11, everything in front of you, just you can substitute all the values, you will get your desired answers, and I hope you understood this question very well. Okay, now let me move with the question number 15. So 12 13 14, I will not go, this is very simple, I hope you solve these questions. Okay, I'll go with the 15. So let me read the question number 15. Okay, a contract on a construction job specifies a penalty for delay of completion beyond a certain date as follow. Okay, rupees 200 for the first day, rupees 250 for the second day, rupees 300 for the third day, etc. The penalty for each succeeding day being rupees 50 more than for the preceding day, more than for the preceding day. How much money the contractor has to pay, okay, as a penalty if he has delayed the work by 30 days. Okay, see, there is one construction work is going on, and the construction, the owner has given to the what, contractor only some times, okay, but he unable to finish that works and he delayed that work. Okay, he delayed. For each delay of the work, how much penalty it is fixed? For the first day it is 200, and for its next succeeding day it is what, 50 plus. Okay, that means first day 200, second day it is what, 250, third day it is 300, like this it is going on. How much day the work, how many days the work will be what here, delayed. So we can say the work will be delayed here 30 days. Okay, so total amount how much, so the contractor has to pay for the owner how many rupees total, the delayed work is what, 30 days. Okay, so what they asked here, how much money, okay, how much money has to pay contractor. Okay, so that we need to find here. Well, now next question number 15. So we'll go with the question number 15. First of all, well, I'll write here question number 15. So first term, what we have? First day it was 200, okay, it was 200, and n is equal to how many days? 30 days the work is delayed. So next, common difference for each succeeding day, how much? 50, isn't it? So these all things we have. Now we can substitute in formula. Sn is equal to n by 2 into bracket of 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So now s of 30 days, okay, this is 30 by 2. So what I'll be do means 30 by 2 means I'll keep 15. Okay, directly I'll keep here. Now 2 into a, so I'll write here 400 plus, okay, n minus 1, I'll write this is 29 into d, we'll get 50. Okay, now 50 into 29, 9 zeros are 0, 9 5s are, we'll get 45. 2 zeros are 0, 2 5s are will get 10, okay. Now this is 0, 5, 4, 1, okay. Next, S of 30 is equal to 15 into bracket of 400 plus this is 1450. Next, okay. So, S of 30 is equal to 15 into bracket of 400 plus 1450. We will get 1850. Okay. Now, we can multiply this one. So, 1850 into 15. Okay. Now, 5 zeros are 0, 5 5s are, will get 25. Okay. So, 2 will come here, 5 8s are will get here, 5 into 8, 8 5s are 40, 40 and 2 will get here, okay, will get here 40, 40 plus 2, 42, okay, 42 will get here. Well, now this is, okay, 42 will get here, 4 is here. Next, this is 5 1s are 5 and this is 9 will get here, 9 into 1 0 1 5 will get 5 here. Now 1 8 will get here 1, 1 8 will get 8, 1 1 1, okay. So we will get here 1. Next, so this is 0, this is 5, 2 7, it is 5 into 2 will get here 7. Now 9 and 8 will get here 17. And this is 1, 2, 7, 7, 5, 0, okay. Now, we will get here S of 30 is equal to 27,750, okay, rupees. So, the contractor has to pay for the owner how much rupees? 27,750 rupees he needs to pay for delaying of the what? 30 days work, okay. So, I hope you understood this question, okay. Next, we have question number 16 here, okay, very simple. So let me read the question first of all. Question number 16, a sum of 700 is to be used to give us 7 cash prizes, is to be given, give us 7 cash prizes. How many cash prizes? Among the 700 rupees, we need to give the what? 7 cash prizes to students of a school for their overall academic performance, okay, overall academic performance. If each prize is rupees 20, if each prize is what, rupees 20 is 20 less than its preceding prize, okay, less than its preceding prize, find the value of each of the prizes, okay, find the value of each of the prizes. Very first of all, what they are given, just you can write here, total how many rupees we have. We have total, question number 16, we have total SN is equal to 700 rupees. Sum 700 rupees we have is to give 7 cash prizes. How many cash prizes? 7 cash prizes to the students of a school of their overall academic performance. Okay. So, let the cost of each, can we know the here cost of the each price? We don't know. So, we'll write here, let the cash of each price rupees X will take, rupees X. Why we have taken this one? Because we don't know that what, how many rupees they are given. That's why we are taken, let the cash of each prize is equal to rupees X we are taken. Okay. Now, how many prizes we have? So, X plus total we have 7. In that, what we need to do means for its next succeeding 20 is minus. So, that means X, if it is X means this is X minus of 20 plus, okay. Next, X minus of 40 plus X minus of 60 plus X minus of 80 plus X minus of, it is 100 plus X minus of 120. Total how many rupees? 700 rupees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is 7. 7 cash prizes. Now, this implies we have this total is 7x, x plus x, 2x, 3x, 4x, 5x, 6x, 7x, okay. Now, total 20, 60, 120, 200 and 300, 320, okay. So 420. So we'll get minus 420 is equal to, we'll get this is 700. Now this implies 7x, this minus becomes that side, means it is plus. 700 plus 420. Now 7x, 700 plus 420, will get how much? 1120. Okay, 1120 will get. Now what is the value of x? So 1120 divided by 7. Okay, now we need to calculate the value of x. So 7 ones are here 7, so remaining how much again? 4 remaining, 42. So 42 means how much it is? Is it 6 possible? 7 5 are 6, okay, 7 6 and this is 0, 160. X is equal to how much we got? 160. Once you got x is equal to 160, now this is here for the first. So x is equal to 160 rupees, one price. Now again 160 minus 20, so 160, each prices we need to calculate here. So this becomes what? 160 minus 20, how much we will get again? 160 minus 20, 140 rupees. Now again we have x minus of third one, 40. So this becomes what? 160 minus of 40 is equal to, we'll get 120 rupees. Next x minus of 60, so 160 minus of 60 will get 100 rupees. Next x minus of, again we'll get here 80, so 160 minus of 80 will get 80 rupees. 80. Next similarly x minus of 100, so 160 minus of will get 100. So how much will get? Will get 60. So last one is x minus of 120 is equal to 160 minus of 120 will get 40 rupees. Okay, now see 160, 140, 120, 100, 80, 60, 40. Okay, so the 7 prices if you added, you will get again how many rupees? Total 700 rupees. Okay, what they told here, find the value of each of the prices. The value of each of the prices is rupees 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, 160. Okay, so this is what each of the prices values we have here. Okay, now next question, we have question number 17. In a school, students thought of planting a trees. Okay, let me read the question first, then we will go with the answers. In a school, students thought of planting a trees in and around the school to reduce air pollution. Okay, in a school, the students were thought about the what? To reduce the air pollution in and around the school. Okay, it was decided that the number of trees, it was decided that what? Number of trees that each section of each class will plant will be the same as the class. Each section of each class will be the plant, will be the same as the class, will be the, if I am studying here first standard, means I need to plant how many trees?